To create a document information record, you can either maintain the transaction code here in the transaction bar, which is CV01N. But what I recommend you is to try to use as much as possible the SAP menu tree. And this is because you will not remember all the transactions, or sometimes you need to find some transactions which you have not used before. And if you know how to use the SAP menu tree, you can easily find any transaction that you want. Now, instead of maintaining the transaction code in the transaction bar, let's find it in the SAP menu tree. I will navigate to Logistics, and then I will scroll down to go to the Central Functions. Here I can go to the Document Management System, and now to Document. And here are the four magical transactions: to create, to change, to display, and to find your documents. First, let's create a document information record. Here you can fill the document number if you want to use an external number, or you can leave SAP to assign an internal number. You have to maintain here the document type, and this is quite important. Let's take a look at the options for document types that we have. You will see here a lot of document types, and you might ask, what's the point of having all these document types if you are creating only documents? Well, it is important, and that's because there is a lot of customizing that sits behind this document type. You will see in the future lessons that all the customizing we will make for our practical example will be linked to the document type. For our simple example, let's choose the document type DRW from Engineering Design Drawing. The document part and the document version, you don't have to fill them, because by default they will get the part 000 and the document version 00, which is the initial document version. Now let's continue, and here we are in the initial screen for creating a document information record. You might now ask, what's the difference between a document, which can be a PDF, a Word document, and so on, and creating a document information record? Well, the document information record will contain all the information which relates to your document. And in this information record, we will then upload our physical document. Let's give a description to our document. I will say assembly pump training. The document status is WR, which is work request. I will show you in the next lessons the document status importance and how this will shape the life cycle of a document. CM relevance, we will keep it blank. If we look at the options, we have two options here. We can make our document not relevant for configuration management or relevant for configuration management. Configuration management is not in the scope of our course, so let's go with the not relevant option. Here the user will be filled by default. In this case, this is my user. The reason why this is important is because you will create documents and you will change a lot of documents. And you want to have traceability of who created the document and who made what changes. And this is why having the user here is important. Then the lab office. This field does not have any fancy customizing behind it, but it is important for reporting. Let's say that your company creates a lot of documents, you know, coming from different departments. By maintaining here an office or a lab, which will point to a specific department, then it will be easier to find your documents. And this is because you will have different filtering options of getting the document from a specific lab. For our example, let's go with the Office PDM, which stands from Product Data Modeling Department. The change number is going to help us to track and to set validity dates for changes. If you don't use a change number, it means that all the time when you make a change to a document, that change is effective immediately. But if you use a change number, then you can control from which date that change is going to be valid. Let's say that I'm going to create now a document. The document is created today. But then I want to make a change, and I want this change to be effective only after 2 months. So in this case, I will need the change number, based on which I can specify from what date the change is going to be valid. We will use change numbers later on in the course. Now let's leave this field blank. The authorization group will allow you to control which users are allowed to change a document or to display a document. You can have different departments in your company, and each department is going to create their own document. And you can set authorization so that only the users from that specific department, they can change and display their documents, but they will not have access to display the other department documents. So any kind of privacy or security concerns, you can address them here. The superior document, this can be used if you're going to have a documents hierarchy. We're going to leave this one blank now, because later on in the course, we will create also hierarchies. And now that we have maintained some basic data in our document information record, let's save it, and then we will come back later on and make other changes. You can maintain here a log field, some text field which can... You can maintain here a log field, which is just a blank... You can maintain here a log field, which is just a blank text, which can help you to track what you have done. So I will maintain here a simple text like... My document started. You have just created probably your first document information record. Congratulations. Let's move to the next lesson.